The Philippine Senate skips the new Bagong Pilipinas hymn pledge during its Monday flag ceremony. Senate President Francis Escudero says the new memorandum circular only applies to the executive branch of government and does not cover Congress, the Supreme Court, and other constitutional commissions. While Escudero sees nothing wrong with the hymn pledge, he has tasked the Senate Secretariat to study the matter. He adds mandating the singing and recitation of the Bagong Pilipinas hymn pledge would require amendments to the flag and heraldic code.
Independent na desisyon nila kung gagamitin nila yan. Dahil ang sinusunod namin ay yung flag and heraldic code na nagsasabi kung ano yung kakantahin kada flag raising ceremony. At hindi lamang ito pagpapaalala sa ating mga sarili. Pagpapaalala din ito sa mga opisyal ng gobyerno na ito ang mga bagay-bagay na pwedeng singilin sa amin ng ating mga kababayang kakanta o aawit nito, lalong-lalo na sa mga paaralan.
The Civil Service Commission defends Malacanang's order requiring the Bagong Pilipinas hymn to be sang in flag ceremonies. Our correspondent Vivian Gulia is now on the line with that story. Viv, go ahead.
Hi, Denise. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s directive for all national government agencies and public educational institutions to integrate the recital of the Bagong Pilipinas hymn and pledge in the conduct of weekly flag ceremonies is well within his power, according to Civil Service Commission Chairperson Carlo Nograles. That's as some senators had said that a law may be needed to authorize it. Nograles, however, noted that for offices outside the executive branch, like the CSC, the practice is only encouraged by the president. The commission will still have to discuss whether or not to implement it. Nograles says he sees nothing wrong with the principles and advocacies pushed for by the Bagong Pilipinas hymn and pledge, as well as with efforts to ensure that government workers are aligned with the administration's goals. Bagong Pilipinas is the Marcos Jr. administration's branding of governance, which the palace said is of a principled, accountable, and dependable government supported by an active and empowered citizenry. The panahon na ng pagbabago calls on the Filipino people to work together for a new Philippines through hard work. The pledge, Panata sa Bagong Pilipinas, meanwhile, is a promise to live according to Bagong Pilipinas by putting the Philippines first and by working alongside others towards national development. But for House Deputy Minority Leader and ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro, she denounces Marcos Jr.'s order as self-serving and reminiscent of his late father's martial rule. Castro called on the president to rescind his directive. She also said that the Marcos Jr. administration should instead focus on addressing pressing problems like the high prices of basic commodities and insufficient wages. Denise, back to you.
Vivian Gulia with that report. Thanks, Viv.
Other news now, Senate President Francis Escudero orders a review of the new Senate building project. That's after the construction cost ballooned from the original 8.9 billion pesos to 23 billion. Escudero said he was shocked by the cost of construction, adding the upper chamber cannot move into the new building this year as the project undergoes review.
Sa aking pananaw, masama ito sa panlasa ng karamihan, lalong masama sa panlasa ng mas nakararami nating mga kababayan, lalo na sa gitna ng krisis sa ekonomiya at sa kahirapang nakikita ng marami sa ating mga kababayan.
The construction of the new Senate building in Bonifacio Global City began under the term of former Senate President Vicente Soto III. Former Senator Panfilo Lacson now explaining the higher cost for the project. According to Lacson, who was chairperson of the Accounts Committee, the higher price tag includes a cost for the building's security system, as well as acquisition fees for the land, whose current real estate value has surged.